No.
Chidabhasa doesn't change. Chidabhasa appears to be changing. Please, sir, understand. Changing, real changing, and appears to be changing is very different. Sun is reflected in the water. Water shakes. Reflection appears to be changing, but reflection doesn't change. Reflection is same. Chidabhasa appears to be shaking. Chidabhasa appears to be having fear. Chidabhasa appears to be having experience. Nothing has happened to Chidabhasa. Whatever is happening to body mind complex, it appears to be going through.
But the reflected whatever is coming out of that changing water, that is also reflected. That is what I am able to
appears to be changing. But in reality, reflection, nothing happens to reflection, no.
Reflection will, suppose it's a colorful, sir, then it color will not be, I will say different colors.
It appears to be, that's what I'm saying. Appears to be and being appears to be. Nothing, what happens to reflection, tell me?
It is different colors I can see.
It appears to be changing. So don't confuse the appears to be changing, real change. Can real change happen in
different? Life will not change. Life will have its own identity only.
That's why you are able to say, oh, I only came, I only this. Even the body mind has changed. Okay? You are able to recollect now. 30 days back I came. Memory is there now. Right? Who came? The body mind has changed. The consciousness has not come. Consciousness is associated with this guy clearly. So you, now for the consciousness, everything is present moment. So the consciousness is recollecting, that means it's recreating the past. A new perception. And all new perception has to happen now.
The old story is in the now only.
Now only.
Complete past to present to future.
So it's again another perception that I was there. Even though the me which was there has changed. The body has changed, mind has changed, intellect has changed, consciousness has not changed, consciousness has not come and gone. Consciousness is, I only came, I only saw, this is my memory. Ashwini?
It's all fabricated, every man.
And that's what is the life, false life. Okay? This moment experience is real. Okay? But experiencing body-mind complex goes. Next, another body come, mind and complex comes. But you still say, I am the same because of Chidabhasa, consciousness, not because of body mind. The continuity is coming from the Chidabhasa. Memory is coming from Chidabhasa, but memory is a recollection. Okay, past. For Chidabhasa has never seen a past. Chidabhasa only can see the present.
Continuity is coming from the awareness only, no? Not from Chidabhasa.
No. Awareness doesn't change. See, awareness is I. It has never changed.
Never changes.
Everything is dependent on awareness. But awareness, nothing has happened. No, nothing can change. Nothing. Awareness doesn't know anything.
Yes.
Right?
Correct.
So everything happening in the manifested world, which is dream.
Yes.
So we are only referring to dream.
Correct. Sir, like you say the example of a dream. If somebody is sleeping and the dream character is changed, that dream character is Chidabhasa.
Dream character is body-mind complex, but body-mind complex is life, that life is Chidabhasa.
Yeah, life, because it is deriving life from that to consciousness.
Consciousness.
I only. So that dream character is changing, right?
The dream character is changing, but the reflection doesn't change. The reflection, the Chidabhasa, has come from I. It is closely resembling I, but it has forgotten I.
Correct. But I, the element that it is having both the I element, the constant element and the changing element. So that I element is continuous, that is not continuous also, it is dimensionless, so it is there, always there.
Yeah.
But this other part, that is the its characteristics, its nature and all that, it is changing.
Correct.
That
appears to be changing. Appears to be changing. Nothing happens to consciousness, reflection. See,
consciousness, nothing happens. So, as you tell, awareness, nothing happens.
No, not awareness.
Okay, Chidabhasa.
Chidabhasa also.
So, Chidabhasa, but it is.
See, the girl in your dream, she grows old, she becomes old woman. Still, she claims I.
Yes.
That I is Chidabhasa.
I is consciousness, awareness.
I is. For her, she doesn't know awareness.
Okay.
For her, I is consciousness, her consciousness, which is Chidabhasa. That doesn't change. That Chidabhasa is same as I is what we are understanding.
So that feeling of I, that character is having that feeling of I, that is not awareness, that is the consciousness, that is the
Chidabhasa.
That is not changing here.
Right? And Chidabhasa is I also, real I also. It's same as. So this guy is confused, the dream character is confused, which is what he doesn't know. He's mixing up everything. So the Chidabhasa of consciousness never sees the past. It's only present always. So if it's recollecting the past, what is there?
Nothing. Fresh.
It's a fresh recollection. It's a fresh perception.
Fresh imagination.
Imagination. Exactly what happens is, you wanted to go to Paris in dream. And you brought a ticket. You don't even ask where the money came from. You assume that money has come because I worked. Like that, moment to moment, your recreation is happening in your consciousness.
So you're saying memory is unreal?
Obviously.
No, unreal in the sense the whole, you know, you said there is functional memory and, you know, the house, so he has to go back to Chennai,
okay.
Even that is unreal.
Okay, let us come to what is unreal part of memory. First thing is all experiences are in the present moment.
Okay.
Chidabhasa can experience only in the present moment, it cannot experience the past.
Yeah.
So when he thinks of the past, okay, the past was present at that time. Past was present only. But one who experiences is the body-mind complex. Experiencing instrument is body-mind complex. That has changed. Right? So what was recorded in your memory? I experienced. Record of that I is body-mind complex. Now if you recollect, this is a different body-mind complex.
The software is moving along with the hardware.
So, okay, let me put it this way.
Normal example, Guruji.
When you take
now in this present moment, he is thinking he is from Chennai. Is that correct or not?
Who is he?
Whatever, the Chidabhasa. You said everything is in the
Chidabhasa doesn't belong to anywhere. Chidabhasa is beyond Tamil
he
and
he got a thought that he is in Chennai. No. He got a thought that he is from Chennai. So is that memory created fresh right now?
Obviously.
Yes.
Obviously. So if he is referring to body and mind,
with a
this body and mind,
that
this body and mind was never in Chennai.
So where did that
so
memory come
from?
It has
undergone
change.
Huh?
It has undergone change now.
What is that? Huh?
Can we say even though jiva and atma is same?
Huh?
Can we separate jiva and atma?
Uh-huh.
Jiva is atma in the body.
Jiva?
Is atma in the body.
Okay.
Divine Atma is not separate, same.
Yeah. That Jiva what I call as Chidabhasa.
Chidabhasa,
if it identifies the body, it's called Jiva.
Yes.
Okay. Now Jiva is the experiencer.
Chidabhasa is going here and there and everywhere.
No. Chidabhasa doesn't go anywhere. Chidabhasa is Jiva only.
Yes.
Jiva
with body.
Okay.
Body goes.
But body which went to Chennai, came back from Chennai, and now body is different. It's not same.
And now, that's what someone said. You say that went, gone and all that. That means you are telling that there is a time. There is a past,
there is a present.
You are missing two levels, Guruji.
See, your question is, did he come from Chennai?
No, I am saying he got a thought in the present moment that he is from Chennai. Is that created fresh now?
Correct. It is created fresh
next
now.
Next moment, it can create a thought that he is from Pune also.
No.
All thoughts are happening in the present. All are happening in the present only.
In that case, why he cannot think that he is from Pune?
Why he has to go back to Chennai?
See,
probability.
No. You have to again look at it. When he experienced Chennai, for the consciousness, it is now. For Jiva, it is now. When he experiences Bangalore, Jiva, it is now. Jiva doesn't know past or future. Okay? Jiva only knows now. Okay? Is it clear? So Jiva was in Chennai. Let's Jiva is body mind complex with consciousness of Chennai. It experienced. Okay? So the experience I call it as a memory is recorded. And that I call as photo. Okay? When you take a photo, does photographer ever appear in the photo?
Why are you bringing past again, Guruji? It never happened.
No. I am speaking of happening now.
Now it's created out of, with the, illogically it's created.
He,
there is no logic at all. If it's creating fresh every moment, where is the logic?
Don't mix up.
You can say Delhi also, Chennai.
Listen carefully what I am saying.
He's explaining how that illogical.
I am trying to, how, where is the illogical happening? I am telling you, trying to do. He, and as a body, mind and complex, a Jiva with the body, experienced Chennai.
When?
Okay.
When it experiences now only, for that. It's always now.
Which is always present.
So now he is experiencing.
See, he was in Chennai, means body mind complex was in Chennai. A consciousness was in Chennai. Through body and mind complex, it is experiencing. So when it is experiencing, it recorded a memory saying that I am from Chennai, I am in Chennai. Okay, when it is recorded, it's present moment only, no? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, when it recorded,
yes. Present moment only. Huh. Recording is like a photo. A photo is kept. Clear? Mm. So in any photo, does a photographer come?
No.
So in your memory, what was kept is the body mind complex which was in Chennai is recorded as my experience.
Okay.
But you said Chidabhasa will not record anything. It won't carry, it won't record.
Arey Baba, record means whatever memory or experience is finally for the Chidabhasa. Yaar. Understand.
Your earlier statement was Chidabhasa has nothing to do with past or memory also.
No, you're listen carefully my logic and then ask the question. You're mixing, many things you are mixing up. Just listen carefully. He or the body mind complex Jiva was in Chennai. Okay. When you are in Chennai, you are experiencing Chennai now only. A photograph is kept, I am in Chennai. Okay. In the photograph, does the photographer come?
No.
Okay. Who is the photographer?
Selfie.
The photographer is Chidabhasa. Okay, Chidabhasa is never recorded. I am experiencing Chennai is recorded. Where is that I am there now? What is that I am?
Body mind.
Existence.
Body mind complex. Yeah. Which is body mind complex. August 15th, body mind complex says is recorded as I am experiencing Chennai. Okay. What is the meaning associated? I am experiencing Chennai for the August 15th body mind complex. First of all, that experience recording, is it correct? I am experiencing body mind, I am experiencing Chennai, body mind complex, is it correct? Because I am is not body mind complex. Okay? So in your memory, recording itself is faulty. First, if it is recorded. Okay? And recording is understood by Chidabhasa, because understanding is only for consciousness, not for the body mind complex. Okay, I am experiencing Chennai is the understanding. Now, okay? So today you are in Bangalore. The body mind complex is now September body mind complex, which is different. True?
September.
No. What is now?
Now that is, sir, what I understand that in this present moment, there are thoughts, not a single thought, having a complete story, like biography from my childhood till now, the complete story is there in this now. Okay? And I am sitting here, I am in Bangalore and all this, this also is in the present now only. Everything in that now only.
Correct. And no, I am telling two things, chronological event and I am telling reality what is happening.
Both can't...
No. I am, for your... See, either when I am explaining to you, I have to tell both happens. Both I have to tell. See, again I am saying it is now only.
Yes.
Right? So, but I am telling dates for people to understand.
That thought is happening in the now, but that thought actually is about the past.
No. That recollection we are not going to still. So, one day in September, August 15th, you are in Chennai.
Okay.
Body mind complex was in Chennai. There was an experience of Chennai for the body mind complex. Okay? Through body mind complex, not for. And the experience is Chidabhasa. So, it recorded, I am in Chennai, is recorded. Is that recording correct, I am asking?
No, again, it's only for the...
Because the body mind is not I. So, I is Chidabhasa. In the memory recording is corrupted. If it's memory recording is happening. It's wrongly recorded as I am in Chennai is recorded wrongly because Chidabhasa or consciousness cannot be anywhere. Okay. So now let us say memory is recorded like that and today if you are recollecting, let us assume that memory is recorded. Today if you are recollecting, I was in Chennai. So that I was is referring to a body mind complex which is August 15th model. Now you are August September model. So is that memory recollection correct?
No.
Okay. This is not correct. Correct recollection.
Correct.
Okay. First level. First level, we assume that it's a memory which was recorded. And but what I'm saying is recording was wrong. Okay. Now recollection also is not correct. Because I was in Chennai is not correct.
This is actually very confusing. Tell us from the real point of view.
Arre Papa, don't.
This is a story actually.
Real part, nothing is happening here.
Yeah, that, no. This is a story. This is confusing.
Next level, where memory is not there. No, you said assuming memory is
there. No, you are asking me a lot of questions.
Not assuming here, please understand step by step. So we'll next.
No, this is cooked up.
No,
next
you understand.
Okay, so start.
Maybe this is, that means, no, Guruji, you mean to say that I was in Chennai is wrong. Asha, 10 years before Asha was in Chennai is right?
See, please, I'll take both the cases. First, understand there's a memory recording and how memory recording is faulty. First, understand it.
That is transactional, what you are saying right now.
No, you have to tell in the transaction world only, no? And the transaction world only, you have to understand what is
there. Transactional world, anyways, we are experiencing.
So then nothing is there, no? Let us sit silently. This is reality.
No, I am asking about the second part of his question.
What is the second part of his question?
In that now everything, you know, the whole...
I am going to tell now, you are not giving me time to do that. You are not allowing me. I am going step by step to make you understand how the things are happening.
The first step itself was not understood.
Okay, so were you in Chennai any point of time?
Okay, the transaction.
No.
Okay, I will tell from the transaction point of view. Okay, yesterday I was in
Chennai.
Yes.
Okay, so yesterday I was in Chennai. It's a memory.
Okay.
Let us assume that memory is recorded.
Memory for now.
No.
It is a memory.
Memory is recorded at that point. Otherwise, you cannot remember.
Okay, it was recorded.
Okay. I was in Chennai, memory is recorded.
Okay.
So, that I refers to what?
Chirabhasa.
Body-mind complex.
That is what Chidabhasa.
Body mind complex is not Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa is powering the body mind complex.
Yes.
This is a complete one unit.
A complete one unit.
Okay.
We are talking about a complete one unit.
In your memory, the recording is about I was in Bangalore, this thing, for this body mind complex. Not for Chidabhasa. You never say Chidabhasa is I.
Sir, without Chidabhasa, it is not live also.
Yeah.
See, understanding of Chidabhasa has come to you only after coming to the class, no?
Yeah.
Now only you are understanding and speaking of Chidabhasa, awareness and all.
Okay.
No, that is
now,
why this question
no,
came up.
No, he's saying from transaction point of view.
For an ordinary person, what he does, he says, I was in Chennai.
Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
Simple.
Suresh, I was in Chennai, that is a record.
Suresh, I was in Chennai. So now, is that from now, this is from Jnana point of view, look at it.
Okay.
This is from our common man point of view.
Yeah.
Common man point of view and Jnana point of view. Common man point of view, I was in Chennai, is it correct?
Yes.
No.
From
common point of view,
the body dated September 11th was in Chennai is correct.
Correct.
Okay, I was in Chennai is not correct.
Yes.
Mm.
No, but I am thinking of, in transaction world, I am thinking about myself as a body, my complex.
No, Raya, this is what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Please understand. There is a common man viewpoint and Jnani viewpoint. I'm trying to tell both of you together. So, so both of you have to understand. For common man, this question doesn't arise. I was in Chennai.
Yes.
I am in Bangalore. The question doesn't arise.
Correct.
So where things are going wrong with respect to Jnana point of view, I am trying to tell you.
Okay. From pure Jnana point of view, it will be very different. It will be like that I was not
in Chennai. There is no Chennai
class.
Please understand, I am telling you common man's viewpoint and Jnana viewpoint at that point, where things are going wrong.
Okay.
So now if you take pure Jnana viewpoint, we don't have anything to discuss. Pure common viewpoint, we don't have anything to discuss.
Correct.
Where the superimposition is taking, I am telling you. So
yesterday I was
wait. First you listen to me carefully and
yes.
After that you ask the question.
Yes.
Now what is happening, you are now interrupt me and not allowing me to talk.
Yes.
So I am a common man. Okay, I was in Chennai August 15th. So I have come to the class on September 12th. I was there. Now you say, are you from Chennai? I'll say, yes, I am from Chennai. Okay, so because I was in August 15 Chennai, this is a common man's viewpoint. For him, there is no confusion.
Yeah.
For Jnani, okay, the I is consciousness, Chidabhasa. Okay, so when you say August 15th, I was there in Chennai, from Jnani's point of view, a simple recording is the body mind complex was there in Chennai. Okay, Jnani's memory is recording properly. August 15th, a body mind complex was there in Chennai. Okay, there is an experience of Chennai on that day. Okay, so now on August 15th recording. Now we come to September 12th. So body-mind complex is experiencing this. So there is a recording of body-mind complex experiencing today in Bangalore. That's experience number one and experience number two. Okay? And both experience number one and experience number two happened in the present moment. For the Chidabhasa is always present. Experience one appeared in present, experience two appeared in the present. Correct? So what was not there in case of Jnani is I am in Chennai or I am in Bangalore is not there. Whereas in case of Ajnani, I am in Chennai or I am in Bangalore is there because both are connected to body. Right? So are you clear about distinction between the, what is Jnani's recording and what is this common man's recording?
Yes.
Common man's Jnani's recording is there is an experience of Chennai, there is an experience of Bangalore. Okay?
Both in the present
moment. That's the experience of Jnani. So now the question comes, were you in Chennai? If you ask the question to Ajnani, he'll say, yes, I was in Chennai because he is a body-mind complex. For Jnani, if you ask the question, were you in Chennai? Hey, there's no answer. The body-mind is not I. The consciousness, I cannot say in Chennai or this thing. Was there an experience of Chennai? Okay.
Even that they cannot say, no, Guruji. Chennai also doesn't exist. For
No. I'm saying, assuming that there's an experience. Experience is real. Like just like your memory, your dream you went to Paris is real.
Yes,
memory experience.
Yes.
Was there experience of Chennai? Yes, there's experience of Chennai.
Yes.
Now where is the experience of Chennai coming? It's coming in the present. Now.
Correct.
Okay. Recollection of Chennai is also happening.
Now.
So only recollection is not happening for a Jnani's point of view. I am in Chennai, I am in Bangalore is not happening. That I am portion is not associated with the experience. Experience itself is there or now, but both recollection also happens now.
Experience
also happens in now.
Experience of the thought, that recollection. Experience of the recollection happens now. And but the recollection actually, that is the thought about whatever happened. That is happening in now only. Recollection is happening in
right.
now only.
But now, the body-mind complex is not in Chennai.
Not in Chennai.
Body-mind complex has changed.
Yeah.
Right? Body-mind complex is not in Chennai, body-mind complex has changed.
Okay.
So there's no experience now. There's no experience of Chennai now.
Yeah.
There's a recollection of experience in Chennai.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So the recollection of experience is reconstructed at this moment in Bangalore.
Reconstructed. Yes. It was there and now again I am thinking about it, that's why I am
reconstructing it.
Okay.
In the present moment.
Okay.
Right? So the reconstruction in case of Ajnani, it is always associated with the body. In case of Jnani, just the experience.
So from the Jnani's point of view, you are saying it has happened in the past. He is recollecting.
There's no past, yeah. It's
experience.
It's always present.
Present.
So now if I say...
So Jnani's point of view, in the present moment, two thoughts have come. One thought is experience of Chennai. Second thought is recollection of Chennai. Both have come right now.
Yes.
The Chennai got created in this present moment is what I am saying.
Thought he got created in this moment.
Thought created Chennai.
Yes.
But
was
there
ever an experience of
Chennai? Can we make it Pune?
No.
Yeah,
Pune
I said instead of Chennai, it could have been Pune also.
Yeah, one screw loose here, it can make Pune also.
So is it not a random thing? Chennai is not a random thing in his case.
Guruji, it's anyway fabricated,
so
we can have
so that's what you are saying. Somewhere you are saying it's not real, but somewhere you are giving the reality to it.
So there, that is a like many choices can be there. Like this one choice, another choice, another choice. Consciousness has taken the option of taking me
Chennai
as Chennai.
As
consciousness could have taken the option
about
of
that.
Pune also.
We are talking about why today. Why do you go back to Chennai only?
Also, why only Chennai?
See, actually he fully dissociated from intellect. He did not go to Chennai. He may go to Himalaya also. He retains the identity with the body-mind
complex.
I'm asking, is it random Chennai?
See, there are many Jnanis. Once getting Jnana, they just wander. They don't know where they are going. Because the connection with the body-mind complex is reduced to zero. So now he has still identified the intellect. Still identification with the sequence. So he will go back to Chennai only. But if he has complete de-identification with the intellect happens, He may just walk from this place and straight away go to Himalayas.
Why are you here, Guruji?
I am not.
I have the identification, no?
You are still identifying with the body.
Yeah, mind. I identify for functional purpose. So there can be total de-identification of the body mind complex.
We are talking from his point of view, I am talking from the universe point of view. How is it creating thoughts in the present moment?
That's
for
what
this
I'm saying.
Body
mind that identity which is taken for the play of role is consistent and continuing.
It's consistent.
And continuing.
It's not random.
See, for example, I'll tell you the story of Shuka Maharaj. Shuka. Vedavyasa Maharshi was a great sage. He is enlightened. Okay. But he lives a life of a householder. And he takes a lot of work writing scriptures and teaching people and all. Very consistent work. Right? If he is completely de-individual body, he cannot do anything. No functional. His prarabdha karma is to teach people of all the scriptures. That's why he is continuing and consistently identification with the body is there and he is doing it. Then for him a son was born. His name is called Shuka. The Shuka, when he was born, it is said that he just walked away. Just walked. The just walking means to sell it, he is nani from the young age. So this guy, this is to tell you nani, different levels of understanding of nani. Okay, this guy Vedavyasa Maharshi calls, oh putra, come back. Shukamuni doesn't even turn back. Who is son, who is father? He just wanders. He has no identification of the body. Okay, so what has happened is that identification of the body is zero in case of Shuka. Some 20% or 30% in case of Janaka Maharaja. The 20 or 30% Janaka Maharaja identification is kept for the function of doing function in the world, some prarabdha karma. Shuka's identification is zero. He has no prarabdha karma. He just walks everywhere. Nothing is there. He doesn't even wear the clothes. Okay? So the story tells that Shukamuni was, and then there's a river. In the river, a lot of women are bathing naked. So they, Shukamuni walks there, they are continuing to bathing. This guy, where the Vedavyasa Maharshi comes calling Shuka, putra, stop, son, oh son, stop. Shukamuni has no concept of son, father, nothing. He has no concept of body also. No identity with body. He just walks. So then, the moment he passes, the moment Vedavyasa Maharshi starts coming there, immediately woman come and wear the clothes. Okay? So these are the stories told in Purana, how Jnana, effect of Jnana. So then Vyasamaharshi asked them, why did you wear the clothes when I came? When Shukamuni came, you didn't even wear the clothes. Then they said, when Shukamuni came, we didn't even feel that he himself has a concept of body. Okay? We didn't even feel our concept of body. But when you came,
we became aware
of our body because you are aware of your body. Okay? So now, Vedavyasamaharshi is also a Jnani. Shukamuni is also a Jnani. Is there a difference between them?
Yes.
The difference in the identification of the body. If the identification of body is there, then your life will be consistent. I was in Chennai, I will be in Bangalore. Tomorrow I am going to write a scripture. So why the identification is there? That's because the intellect identifies the consciousness, at the same time it identifies the body. The identification has not gone to zero. Okay? So you maintain sequence of events. That's why you are able to do some service and continue to work. If the identification goes zero, there's no work can be done. He just walks around. He doesn't even know where he goes. It's like a child. Child doesn't know no father or mother. So these are two extreme cases of Jnani. So we should not mix. One I told you case of Ajnani, one case of Jnani. For Vedavyasa Maharshi, he knows the world is illusion. World is mithya. But still he retains identity of the body to do some work in the world. Whereas for Shukamuni, there's no world is illusion, the body is illusion. He has no identity of the body. So all of us will be in between somewhere, either poor Ajnani or some Jnana. Okay? The some Jnana is required to do some consistent work in the world. Then you have a consistency. I was here in this thing, yesterday I wrote this book, yesterday I gave this lecture, the consistency is there. Even though you know everything is mithya, you have a consistency. Memory is there, but you don't give importance to that memory. Or rather, reality to the memory. Whereas in case of a Jnani, like Shukamuni, there's no memory recording because the body is not dying. It's like a child, just keeps going. Okay. So now if you ask, why did he, why, tomorrow, yesterday he was in Chennai, why can't he recollect that he is in Pune? He cannot recollect because the intellectual body, mind and consciousness, they are working consistency. The work is pending. The prarabdha karma is pending. Okay? So that's why there are four levels of jnani. Brahmavid, Brahmavara, Brahmavarenya, Brahmavarishta. They are called four levels. So what is this four level? Brahmavid is a category where he has atmajnana. What is atmajnana? I am Brahman. Okay, he has a jnana, the world is mithya, world is unreal. This jnana is therefore clearly for all, no difference. In case of a jnani like Vedavyasa Maharshi or Shri Krishna, they are very clear, I am Brahman and world is mithya. But they are very clear, I need to do some work in the world, loka kalyana. For that, there is a body-mind identity, intellectual identity is there. Okay. Then there is a consistency, then there is a past, present and future, because body, mind and identity is there. It is known as unreal, but still identity is there. It is like sitting in a movie, know that it is a movie, you enjoy. Whereas in case of a Brahma Varishta, he just walks out of the movie, no movie. Brahmavid is in the movie, knowing very well the movie is there and participates in the movie meaningfully. For that there is a time and space consistency there because he is living in the two worlds. World of Maya and world of reality. He retains that identity. That's why one moment he doesn't think I am in Chennai and one moment he can't think in Hyderabad. Okay. So now comes to the Brahmavara, Brahmavarenya, Brahmavarishta. They progressively what will happen? Their interaction with the world will come down because body mind identification comes down. Why it comes down? Only because of prarabdha karma, pending work. Okay. In case of Brahmavarishta, he has no identification with body. He doesn't know what is past, what is present. He doesn't know what is future. He is like a child. Many times Brahma Varishta has to be fed by somebody else. Something has to be brought. It's called Ajagara. Python. So python doesn't go anywhere for food. Food has to come into mouth. A jnani of Brahma Varishta nature doesn't go anywhere. He just sits. For him there's no time, no space, no Chennai, no Bangalore, no Hyderabad. It's just there. So somebody gives the food, he will eat. Somebody doesn't give the food, he doesn't eat. Okay. So there the body mind addition has come to zero. He doesn't interact with the world because mithya nature is very clear and he has no prarabdha karma left in that body mind complex. Whereas in case of Brahma Vidya, the prarabdha karma is left. So he lives as a jnani, he interacts with the society, he contributes meaningfully to society and till the prarabdha karma becomes zero. Okay. So now, suddenly the jnani will think that, oh, I am in Hyderabad, I am Chennai. In one sense, yes, he is in Hyderabad, he is in Chennai, he has a consciousness. But as a body-mind complex, I was in Hyderabad, the body-mind complex in Hyderabad, body-mind complex in Chennai, that consistency is maintained. Nothing happens to the consistency. Logically, nothing happens. Are you able to understand the distinction?
Yes. So the third person, he doesn't have the idea of space and time at all.
No.
So that is no past, no future,
no.
Nothing.
No. He doesn't even know he is a body.
So he is a born jnani. If he is born jnani and he has no prarabdha karma left, then why is he born?
Why is he born?
Will be
there. There will be prarabdha karma for teaching people. Shukamuni is the only one who taught Bhagavatam to all the people. So for you to Bhagavatam to me, you have taken a body. That not prarabdha karma in our sense. He has come for teaching. See, jnani, there is some sort of this thing, okay. So what I am saying, sometimes jnani does because of his prarabdha karma, sometimes jnani does for loka kalyana. Is the distinction clear? So the memory recording in case of jnani, I am in Chennai, Chennai is real, I am in Chennai is real. For in case of jnani, Chennai is unreal, body mind is real, I am not in Chennai is also clear. But for functional purpose, I am the body, I am using the body is clear. So then he will say, I came from Chennai. But he has never a concept that I am Chennai, I was in Chennai. He knows that Chennai is a movie. Bangalore is a movie. Okay, it's as if you are operating in a 3D movie. The clarity is there. But still he operates. Because of his residual prarabdha karma. If your residual prarabdha karma was zero, you will never come here. You don't even go to Chennai. You don't know where you go. Okay. That's what happened to Ajja. Our guru, he had enlightenment. He almost died and came back. His name was Gopal Krishna. he was married and he had a wife and children and agricultural land. So he had some severe disorder, disease. He died. Then somehow he recovered. Then everybody was happy. Wife was happy that he recovered. Then the moment he woke up, he said, the one who died and one who woke up is not same. He just walked away. Doesn't remember his wife, he doesn't remember children, just walking. He went on and on and on. He doesn't even know where to go. Doesn't wear the clothes, just walks. So then he goes to some place, then somebody told him you have to go to Vajreshwari to meet Nityananda Baba. That Nityananda, that's the dark fellow is there, person is there. So then Nityananda Baba tells him, go back to your place, stay there. So then he comes and stays here. His wife is there, but he doesn't know. His children are there, his wife, children, agriculture, nothing. He comes and stays in Puttur, but he doesn't know anything. Listen, please. So that's the extreme case. Brahma with Brahma, Vara, Brahma, Vara. Pradha Karma has come to zero. Then some people, some Jnanis are born. They don't have Pradha Karma. They are born Jnanis. They have come to teach something to the world and go. It's not by karma. They are by, they, because of the universe wants something to teach. Shukamuni was born just to teach people Bhagavatam. Okay. So like that it happens. So now I am telling you what is the exact mechanism which is happening. That you have to understand how it applies in life. You have to understand the moment I say you are not body mind, the whole body mind Chennai, Bangalore doesn't disappear. Because your prarabdha karma is there. So you start understanding this is mithya and I am satya. You should, same wife, same husband, but the way you look at it and live will be different. And less impression will happen because I am not the body, I am not the mind intellect. Now, any recollection is not real because recording is not real. Okay. Is this much clear to all?
Yes. For any recollection to happen, there has to be an experience in the first place, no?
Yeah. Experience was there. Experience of Chennai was there. It's recollected. But it's recollected as I was in Chennai is not correct. The body mind complex is in Chennai. The body mind complex is chained.
No, sir.
No, that's a
can't it be reverse actually? Because of recollection, that experience is there. Because of experience, recollection happens, she told. I'm telling you, because of recollection. Because like suppose now I recollect that I was in Pune.
You are saying a fabricated experience.
Yes.
A fabricated experience also happens in case of mental disorders.
No, not also. Because how I can be know that I was in Chennai? Because of only recollection only. Because only of
correct,
recollection.
What I'm saying
nothing
is,
else can able to say. Maybe five people can say that I was in Chennai.
No. What I'm saying is, you have to see, is there a consistency in your experience? Okay. So that consistency in most of the people, it's an order and sequence.
Consistency means?
I was in Chennai.
Every.
I'm so and so.
That some identity which is there, intact and consistent, is there. Okay. So now it's consistent also. The story is consistent. So now suddenly you get an impression that I was in Hyderabad or Pune. So that also can happen to many people. They're called mental disorder. So when the mind is working properly or the intellect is working properly, there's a consistency in the story. Even the story is mithya, unreal, there's a consistency in the story.
But that consistently, completely, when you say consistent, no, that is all actually because of our thought, no?
Correct. What I'm saying is that the thought, because of your parakrama, that gives a very consistent story. Because of your some.
Yeah, I was born there and I was there, and like that, this complete story. It is now appearing like the complete background is appearing in this now.
Correct. What I'm saying is that is story only. Depending on the paradakama, if paradakama is zero, you say every story is false and you just walk away from here. You may probably walk away naked also. The very fact that you are not doing it, you are giving some reality to the story.
Yes. Prabhuji, irrespective of whether we identify or not, irrespective of the individual, but it is that everything is in the present, irrespective of what we
it
see,
is
what the, we think, what is our
all experiences, is our, all experiences are in the present.
That is what not able to digest that.
Yeah, did you have any experience has to happen in the present only, no?
No, that recollection is also in the present.
Yeah, if you recollection can
not happen in the past, how can you recollect? Is
yes.
My question.
No. That is what I'm saying. See, as long as you have identification with the body and
mind,
the story is a consistent story.
There is a past, there is a story.
There's a consistent story is there.
Okay.
In storyline, the consistency is there.
Okay.
If the storyline inconsistency is there, he may say, I was in Chennai, but recollected in Hyderabad. So that means there is some disorder is there in the mind.
Okay,
that is the case when you are identified with the body mind. And then I say that I was in Pune, means that is a
disorder.
Identification is not there. So even Pune, Chennai, nothing will be there.
If identification is not there, why you sit anywhere? You'll just walk. Right? Without dress or anything, you'll walk, no? So what I'm saying is, please understand, there is a, some degree of consistency is there when you identify the body mind complex. That doesn't go. Even though you have intellectual understanding, that doesn't fall off to zero.
Okay.
If fall off to zero, you are like a Shukamuni.
You will not identify the place also.
You will not identify anything. Name, anything. You just walk. Doesn't you recognize father? Just walk.
Yeah.
If the identification is some X degree, 10%, 20%, you are consistent. So then you have a story. Then you have a storyline that you say, you know the storyline is not real, but still you say, this is my story.
I was born here, I lived here.
But you won't be attached or
what?
You won't dwell on
my
it.
My body today is different from me.
As long as you understand.
Not yes, 10 minutes back.
This is all temporary. And
10 minutes back.
That moment is gone.
Not the
yeah.
same. This is different.
You don't
yes.
have to think
correct.
About it.
So can we say this? So when you are relating the story of Vedavyasa and Shukamuni, you are recollecting in the present moment.
Right.
In the same way, you correct, you recollect, you in the sense, present Prabhuji, you can recollect in the same manner that you went somewhere and you came back and you took a class. In the same manner it happens, as if it is some other story which you have just related.
For me, the story, there is no sense of I. I'm
some,
just
some
I'm just narrating it. I'm just narrating a sort of a sort of movie. So there's no sense of deep reality to that. Even though I have experience, that experience doesn't leave any impression to me. Very little impression.
You can just recollect as if you're recollecting some XYZ story.
Yes.
Not me per se.
There's nothing personal.
Correct.
Okay, I'll just give you one real thing which happened last 3 months. Right, one real thing which happened. Real means it's happened. Okay, I have a Gayatri also to collaborate. You want recording or stopping? If you record, you keep it private. Okay, in last few months.